are the never-ending saga of celebrity drama. Taylor Swift, the maestro of lyrical revenge, is back in the spotlight. And this time, she's not holding back. In a recent Time interview, she spilled the tea on the still painful aftermath of the infamous Kim Kardashian Snapchat scandal. And boy, does she have a lot to say. Let's rewind a bit for those who missed the first act of this drama-filled saga. Back in 2020, the world was rocked by the release of full footage of a phone call between Swift and Kanye West. Remember that whole famous debacle? Yeah, it was messy. Kardashian even took to Snapchat to share snippets of the conversation, leading to a tidal wave of backlash against Swift. But here's the kicker. Swift's rep, Tree Payne, swooped in with the truth bomb, revealing that Swift was never informed about West's plan to use the word bitch in his song. Talk about a plot twist. Fast forward to 2023, and Swift is still feeling the sting of betrayal. In her Time interview, she pulls back the curtain on just how deeply the scandal affected her. From fleeing to a foreign country to avoiding phone calls like the plague, Swift paints a picture of psychological warfare like no other. And what about Kardashian? Well, according to Swift's sources, there's been nary a peep of apology from the Kardashian camp. Talk about adding insult to injury. But fear not, dear readers, because Swift isn't one to stay silent. Oh no, she's channeling her inner Greek goddess with her latest masterpiece, Cassandra. Drawing inspiration from the mythological figure cursed with the gift of prophecy, but doomed to be ignored, Swift weaves a tale of betrayal and hypocrisy fit for the ages. In Cassandra, Swift doesn't just throw shade, she serves up a piping hot roast, calling out the Kardashian-Jenner clan and their love affair with cold, hard cash. And let's not forget the not-so-subtle jab at their public displays of Christianity. It's enough to make you clutch your pearls and reach for the popcorn. So why Cassandra, you ask? Well, it's simple. Swift sees herself as the modern-day prophetess, warning the masses of the snakes in their midst. And mark her words, she's not backing down anytime soon. In the end, Cassandra isn't just a song, it's a battle cry. A reminder that no matter how hard they try to silence her, Swift will always have the last word. And boy, does she know how to make it count. My name is Zoe. Remember to subscribe, like, and comment. Until next time, ciao ciao, my fabulous peeps. Thank you for watching.